الراشدين. أما بعد، السلام عليك يا عالمة غير معلمة وفاهمة غير مفهمة. صدق عليكم السلام. صدق إمامنا السجاد عليه الصلاة والسلام. On this auspicious day of the birth of Lady Zainab Salamullahi Alayha, I extend my heartiest felicitations to Imam of our time, Hujjat ibn al-Hasan, Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman alayhi salam. And to all the mu'mineen and mu'minat gathered here and worldwide. And I pray to Almighty Allah that in the name of Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayha, may Almighty Allah bring the peace to entire universe through the zuhur of Hujjat ibn al-Hasan, Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman, Ajjalallahu ta'ala. In today's world, people are still searching for a key to success. They want to find a solution which could just be plugged in into the door of success, and with a switch, turn of a switch, the success should flow towards them. Why? Because those in the past who were learned, their knowledge has turned into ignorance because of the local technology and latest technology. And those who are learned, and those who have experience, and those who have become graduates, they find themselves out of job. The more they try to find, the more they don't get any job. The experiences are turning to nothing. They are not working. The past methodologies of businesses are failing. All methods of running around, advertising, everything is falling apart. A human is in search for this small key that would just act as a starter, like a car key, that you would just turn on that car and you would start just with one gear and in the automatic mode, and the car would move. But they don't find the success key. Where is that success key lying? Is it under some business? Is it under some idea? Is it under some knowledge? Every method has been tried, but nothing seems to be working. Alhamdulillah, the religion of Ahlul Bayt not only provides us the key and the ingredient of the key to us of success, rather it also provides us with a methodology of using that success key in the right manner, so that the success would just flow towards it as the water of the river flows towards the sea. You may have seen that there are places, some places where there is a dispenser of bubble gum for the children. They just insert the coin, turn the knob, and the bubble gum flows towards them. But then sometimes there is a mistake. One coin gets stuck, and with one round, several of bubble gums just flow out towards him. Is there that method in the system of Almighty Allah that with one turn, all the success flows towards us? Yes, there is. And that is shown in the advent of Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayha. Almost majority of the 30 principles of success are all available in the movement of Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayhi. From seeking of the goal, defining the goal, to persistence, to planning, and the list just goes on. And Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayha, in her 1 year of persistence and sabr, she just made and she overturned all the plot that Yazid had and the Banu Umayyah had carried in their mind throughout 50 years of power and hatred. And Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayha within 1 year overturned everything. And she brought success in such a way that she never hurt the enemy. She never hit back at the enemy. She never told anything to the enemy. But she eradicated, or rather she made a distinction between what was right and what was wrong. And that was not only for the past. Up till now, all the rights that have been fought by the people, and the distinction that human has between right and wrong is all following the principles laid by Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayha. But what is those 30 ingredients? They are, I will not go on the 30 ingredients, I will go on the main ingredient. Above all those 30 ingredients that are known to humankind now, there is one ingredient that is the heart and the soul of all the success of Sayyidah Zainab Salamullahi Alayhi. And that is the obedience of Almighty Allah through the obedience of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. Besides all the persistence, think about the lady who has lost her entire family. Her entire family has been brutally murdered in front of her eyes. The lady is not only free, she is not free. She is captivated, she is a captive, she is imprisoned, she is standing in front of the power of the time. And that also not a just power, a tyrant of the time who doesn't have any humanity in him, who doesn't believe in any principles of humanity, such an ignorant and tyrant person, and she is chained in front of this tyrant with the heads of her family, severed heads of her family in front of her eyes on the spear, and the orphans of his brother just around him, around her. And at that time, with all that sabr and all that persistence, the way she starts her khutbah and she says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. That trust in Almighty Allah, that obedience to Imam al-Husayn alayhi salatu wasalam. When she is about to enter the darbar of Yazid, she stops there because it has hurt her integrity to an extent that human cannot forbear. But now Sayyidah Zainab, with all that power and majesty that she commands in her hand, even now, she doesn't agree to enter the courtyard of Yazid. And she sits down and she says, if you don't follow my instructions, if at all you don't follow my conditions, I will not enter into this courtyard. Rather, I will seek adab and I will do bad-du'a for this ummah. And she sees the tears in the eyes of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salatu wassalam. Oh, my sister Zainab, no more of bad-du'a for the ummah. Just follow where the ummah is leading you and just keep your head down. And Sayyidah Zainab just stands up from there. She doesn't ask her brother, what about my integrity? What about my rida? What about my izzah? She is the daughter of Lady of Light. She is the daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Her blood, in her blood is running the blood of the Holy Prophet. She is the flesh and blood of the Holy Prophet. With the instruction of Imam, she just follows the instruction of Allah and she doesn't care about her integrity or anything. It is the instruction of Almighty Allah she believes. That is the instruction of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is the main ingredient that the lady who is lying in Sham today also is granting the desires of whoever visits her. No, she grants the desires of those who can't reach her and they seek their desires from far and about. Why? That is the secret of her success. That is the reason when this day, on this day of the 5th of Jamadi al-Ula, when the lady Zainab salamullahi alayha was born, at that time Sayyidah Fatima al-Zahra salamullahi alayha. Requested Amir al-Mu'mineen to suggest a name for this girl. And Amir al-Mu'mineen requested Lady of Light, Fatima alayha salam, to recommend a name for this lady, for this young child. But both the parents agreed not to precede the Holy Prophet. Therefore they waited for the Holy Prophet. And the Holy Prophet entered the house after doing salam, after giving salutations at the door. As-salamu alaykum ya ahla baytin nubuwa wa ma'din al-risala wa mukhtalafi al-malaika. This is the door where nubuwa has been completed. This is the door where the malaika descend after giving salutation and taking permission at the door of Fatima. The Holy Prophet enters and he gives the glad tidings and he congratulates the parents and then he asks, what is the name of this child now? And the parents say, Ya Rasulallah, we cannot precede you in keeping the name of this child. When you are there, you will suggest the name. And the Holy Prophet says, if you are the parents and you don't precede me in keeping the name of this lady, then how can I precede Almighty Allah, my Creator? And while Rasulullah was saying this, Jibreel descends from the skies and he says, Almighty Allah sends you salutations, O Prophet. And he says that Almighty Allah has kept the name of this lady as Zainab Salamullah. This is the reason of this success of Sayyida Zainab. This is Zainab. This is the zina of Amir al-Mu'mineen. This is the beauty of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Ali is a beauty in himself, is a complete beauty in himself, who is a ma'asum, who is a complete. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, the Holy Prophet says, I cannot mention your fada'il for I'm afraid this ummah will take you as God. Therefore, I have to hide your fada'il, your qualities. I cannot describe what you are in actual essence. That is the complete Ali and his beauty. He has been beautified by the daughter called Zainab Salamullahi Alayha. I pray to Almighty Allah to grant us tawfiq to follow in the footsteps of Ahlul Bayt and especially Sayyida Zainab Salamullahi Alayha. And may Almighty Allah grant us understanding of the religion of Ahlul Bayt alayhim afdalus salati was salam. And I pray to Almighty Allah to hasten the reappearance of Hujjat ibn al-Hasan sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman alayhi salatu was salam. واجعلنا من أعوانه وأنصاره وشيعته ومحبيه والثائرين تحت لوائه والمستشهدين بين يديه. I enjoin myself and the mu'mineen to hold on to taqwa, for taqwa is the only solution for human in this world and the next. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. There is a woman who is going through an operation. And there are some mu'mineen who have requested for Shifa al-Marda. We request one surah Shifa al-Marda for all the ill. Marda, Bismillah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله ونحمده ونستعينه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وآله ومغفرته ورضوانه. اللهم صل. And a little in Arabic also. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. الناس يبحثون عن مفتاح النجاح. الأسئلة التي تنشئ هي كيف ينبغي أن نحصل عليه؟ ماذا علينا أن نفعل؟ ودرب من متابعة مثل هذه الأسئلة. إنهم لا يدرون ما هو مفتاح النجاح. ولكن دين أهل بيت عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام يكشف عنا طريقة إلى النجاح والفلاح، وإنها لا تتوقف عند هذا الحد، بل يرشدنا إلى كيفية استخدام مفتاح النجاح بواسطة الأمثلة العملية، مثل السيدة زينب سلام الله عليها. السيدة التي واجهتها جميع أعظم الفضائح، قتل إخواتها وأولادها أمام عينيها بقسوة، وكانت تقف أمام طاغية زمانها، وكانت رؤوس مقطوعة على الرماح أمام عينيها، والأيتام من أهلها حولها. في هذه الحالة لن انزلق قدميها أبدا، لأنها اتكل على الله من خلال الطاعة لأهل البيت عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام. ولذا من واجب علينا من واجبنا أن نتبع على خط أهل البيت لنجاحنا وفلاحنا، وهذا هو حل كامل ومفتاح النجاح. أدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا في طاعته، وأن يجنبنا من معصيته، وأن يعجل لنا ظهور سيدنا ومولانا الإمام المنتظر عجل الله تعالى فرجه. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك ونبيك صلاة نامية زاكية ترفع بها درجته وتبين بها فضله، وصل على محمد وآل محمد وبارك على محمد وآل محمد كما صليت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل على أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب. اللهم صل على محمد. السيدة فاطمة الزهراء سلام الله عليها. وسيدا شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين وأئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي